And it was when I was still looking for teaching jobs as an act, as Miss T this time, or Ms. T. And I was getting fingerprinted. Now they do it with electronic stuff, but it was still at the time where I went to someplace, an office supply store or something in Santa Rosa, and this would have been around 1998, maybe, 97, 98. And there was a young man there who was doing it. So, you know, put my fingers in the ink and then roll them on the paper. And he was like handling it, doing it. And I went in and had that whole process done. We, you know, joked around and I paid for what I had to pay for and all that. And went out to my friend and went, hey, I just did it. Somebody was actually physically, you know, appropriately and physically touching my body. And as female, and I was not worried about it, and he, even if he had suspected something, he didn't show it and didn't care. So I did it, and the confidence that I got from that was thrilling. And so the confidence builds up on it, and it builds up on itself. And that's why I think that I don't have any problems now in public, is because I'm very confident about my right to be in the world the way I choose to be in the world. So that's kind of an interesting aspect of it, and this whole idea of gender privilege. And then there's you know, other things that have gone on with privilege too. You know, I mean, you'll discover some more of that too. Let's see what else. So employment. That's another big thing when you're moving in into, you have to have some income. So I tried to get teaching jobs, and I could not get one. And although I did a long-term substitute in the school that I taught as male in Mendocino County, they hired me back for a long-term substitute for a maternity leave. And so I went back as Miss T. And so that was a major thing in this little school, a K-8 school in Mendocino County, to have me come back as transgender female. And so there was this whole education process. They sent the letter home. My therapist went up to the school and talked to the staff and faculty about me and the transition so they would understand what was going on, because, you know, people don't know. And then they talked to the lawyers to see if they could avoid it, and because I had seniority and they had to hire me back. And they crafted a very good letter to send home to parents. So it was all out in the open. There was nothing hidden. And they had their kids had an assembly, and they asked the questions that they wanted to ask. And so everybody was kind of prepared. But I will tell you what that was like the first day of coming back. And everybody knew I was going to come back, and it was in like in March or something. So the school year was well underway. And when I got there, I had to go to the office and, you know, talk to the principal and sign some papers, et cetera, et cetera. Then I had to go to the classroom to meet with the teacher who I was going to substitute for, who was going on maternity leave. And the principal said, "Let's go. We'll walk over to the classroom," which, you know, it's outside campus, right? And it happened to be break, morning break. And so when I walked out, there were all these kids. The place went silent. So it's like walking a gauntlet. And I'm like, I'm in my green dress. I look stunning. And after that initial, that's trial by fire, I'll tell you. But I succeeded. I did it. And there was, you know, during the course of the school, the rest of the school year, there were some problems with some of the students who mostly influenced by their parents. But we all worked it out. So the school psychologist, which they might not exist anymore, I don't know, but she was very, very helpful. She was extremely supportive. And really supportive of me, but also the children and the parents. So all the questions were addressed right up front and forthrightly, and nobody's feelings were discounted, and nobody was forced to do anything. So it all worked over a period of time. And and now things are much better. I mean, we're talking about 1998, and here we are, 13 years later, and things are much, much better now. It's not quite as unknown as it was. Thanks a lot to the internet, but also television and cable and all of that. There's a lot of information.